Hello there, and welcome back to some more Dragon Quest Builders 2. In the last episode, what we did was we upgraded our base. Well, we're going to upgrade our base this time. We built a cafeteria, we built a armory, we built a training room in the other corner, and now we're going to upgrade the level of the base. Ring that shit straight away. And then ring. Hit her! Base level 3. Soldiers learn new ability, Spinning Slice. Population of Deceptor's base just got a little bigger. Yes. Just learns a load of new recipes. Carpet, fancy carpet, stained glass window, carpeted steps, throne room door, candle, altar, bench, throne. Got a statue, decorative drapery, curtain, stage curtain, bulb banner, and big bulb banner. Katsuki's just have a sort of incredible clang. Nobody rings a bell quite like you. Carpet block, thrones, and goddess statues, even altars, it would seem you have rather grand ambitions for this place. And our forces continue to swell, with ever more soldiers drawn here by the peal of the builder's bell. It is not only in numbers that our strength has increased, it would seem the castle guard have now mastered spinning slices, too.
Well done, young builder. My kingdom goes from strength to strength. It soon will soon be strong enough to defeat the monsters once and for all, yes.
First things first, so let's bid these new arrivals a hearty welcome to Moonbrook Castle, their new home. Are you the one who rang the bell? We had all heard the rumours of Moonbrook's revival, but none of us expected to see it thriving like this. When we fled, we thought our soldiering days were over, but I was clearly wrong. The castle really is in fighting shape. The soldiers in green tabards are trained healers, just so they can cast multi-heal to keep all of us alive that much longer. Now that I think about it, I never told you what the other coloured uniforms mean, did I? Allow me to explain. Soldiers in blue are strong, steadfast footmen. They can use spinning slice to take down hordes of monsters all at once. Warriors in red are members of the Royal Guard. We're in charge of ensuring King's Majesty's safety. We can also cast a buff to bolster everyone's defences. Well, now that we've all been introduced, I hope you don't mind if we add our strength to your own. For Moonbrook! 6 new soldiers move to Moonbrook Castle. I'm gonna have to extend my bedroom. Because this shit ain't enough. That's for sure. Also, now I need to make yet more swords. This should be enough. Yeah, now they're all getting weapons. Lovely jabbly. Okay, Warwick, I rang the bell. Jolly good show, Joseph, swinging that bell to inspire the townspeople have added new troops to our cause, too. And we're not concerned that there might be a spy among their number. That's certainly a possibility, but the last thing we need is to start doubting each other. We have enough enemies as it is without making enemies of ourselves. Who or who is your enemy? Is it any you? Is it any me? Who should we trust? Who should we hate? Find out we must before it's too late. Ugh. Anyway, there's one person I trust, it's you, Joseph, and I do hope you feel you can trust me too. I have a little doubt who our next enemy will be, the Abominable Air Force. We must find a way to defeat them before, well, yes, before it's too late. Time goes short, Joseph, so you and Anessa must begin work on another magical weapon to help defeat the Air Force. Indeed, the fiends fly right over our current defences. We have to identify their weaknesses and modify our fortifications to take advantage of it. But before that, let us begin by laying out another blueprint to expand upon our current system of walls and traps. We can add whatever invention we come up with to handle the Air Force later. Be sure to leave space for it when laying out your design. Okay. Alright, let's see here. Yes, sir. Three kinds of rock. Sedimentary, igneous. Forget the other one. I'll find out for you. An anti-air force fortifications blueprint. More castle wall, more castle wall butchers, more castle battlement, more castle corners. Ladders. Zap traps, spike traps, barricades, snares, pressure plates, and something we do not know. You're finished already? Goodness me, it's enormous. You certainly don't waste any time, do you, Josephus? Locations marked with question marks are for your new anti-air force device, yes? Just like when you left space with the snares last time. What a blueprint, what a plan, but our force is strong indeed. Or our foe is strong indeed. I should give what aid I can, I think I have a lead. A lead, hmm? Ask him what he means by that, would you, Josephus? I don't think so. I know the second to listen to his caterwauling. Transport along will start work on the blueprint. As soon as you prefer, it's a chest well stocked with pieces of castle wall and any of the sundries we'll need. Of course, we won't be able to finish it off until you've invented the magical weaponry to fill in the blanks. So go, Josephus, and discover our enemy's weakness. I will in a minute, but I've got to build this shit for my friends, so... And then to put it all in the chest again. I'm just going to use like 100 at a time. Because I'm going to have to do this at least one more time for the next set of things, so it doesn't really matter. Okay. All this shit in the box. Right now. And now get to work. They won't do it while the fighting's going on, that's true. I've travelled to every corner of this island, bringing my blessing of song to every far-flung region, and picking up a lot of incredibly useful information along the way. You wish to learn more about the Air Force, yes? Well, their camp lies through a valley south of Moonahan, deep within a poisonous swamp. Perhaps you should pay them a call. Come then, we can infiltrate the enemy forces, making wise use of the mod rod, just as we did before. Our heroes depart for the enemy fort, in the poison swamp's heart, their war plans to thwart. Best of luck. Before you go, please do be sure to place all the materials you need to complete the blueprint in the chest. Trade first to have to down tools while you're away. Hey, don't worry about it. I guess I should wait for these. Kill them. Yes, flame sword. Kill. I was like, what's this different sound effect? Then I realized it's me. But I am killing them. Bye bye. You'll flee eventually. You can't keep this up. Reach if you wanted to attack you. Pack him. Come in, mate. If you want in, you ran away. Okay. Just gonna let him in. If you want to come in, you'd be free to do so. Just actually come in. Beautiful. Of this shit in now. Now I can go. Anessa, to me. You know, if they want to be here, all they have to do is not come from that entrance, though, don't you? An interesting development. Do I get my mod rod out? Sounds ruder than it is. Yeah. Mod my rod. Hello, Zombol.
There's a beautiful, stinking swamp through here. It's a great place to rest, relax, and enjoy the fetid aroma. Or at least it used to be. Now it's full of squawking, nattering bird monsters. I can't stand it.
Here we go. Mission Infiltration Station is a go. Don't run. Don't get take damage.
Hey, you, what are you slackers doing wandering around? If you've got nothing to do, I'll find something to keep you busy. Go and gather more flurry feathers. If we don't have enough for particularly blithery breeze, it's all it will take to leave us absolutely helpless. If it's funny to think that the same thing could stir up the greatest Gallus and all those who's the strongest squalls. Gales. Recently, the skies have been growing darker. The skies. Recently, the skies were growing darker by the day. The whirlwind whipped up while we were in the air. With curtains for us. That's why we need flurry feathers. So we can tear down Moonbrook Castle without breaking a sweat. Scree-hee-hee! The other gremlins should have collected their quota by now, though how about you go and gather them up and bring them back here? So the Air Force are vulnerable to strong winds, are they? I wish you could build something rather interesting from the flurry feather things. Let's follow this fiend's instruction and see where it leads us. Hey, let's stop your nattering. Find those gremlins and bring me my flurry feathers. I won't be satisfied until I have all six. Kree, the gremlin in charge sent you to collect the flurry feathers, but I found mine, but then I lost them again. I didn't want anyone to steal them, you see, so I hid them in the poison swamp, then completely forgot where I put them. And I remember seeing an old crate floating in the water somewhere nearby. Perhaps you could find them for me.
So the feathers were in the swamp, the deadly poisonous one. Well, what are we waiting for? Let's dive in. But Moroth, we don't need to dive headfirst into danger. Just ever since simply drain the poison using his bottomless pot. Yeah, but he can't use his tools in his as a monster, can he? Then we need but find a safe place from the prying eyes of the monsters to assume human form. Then we can search near the crate and find the flow feathers at our leisure.
The supervisor sent you to collect up all of our flurry feathers. Certainly, I stored mine safely in this storeroom. Say, what are a bunch of wingless wonders like you doing in the Air Force? You can't even fly. This all seems very suspicious to me. But if the supervisor sent you, everything must be above board. Give me a second and I'll lock the door for you. There you go, all unlocked. The flurry feathers are in the chest. Go on in and help yourselves.
Wait, is that the Mirror of Ra? What's going on? We changed back into humans again. Just as I thought, the mirror, it's...
What's going on in there? Did you find the flurry feathers yet or... Three? You humans! Spies! They will get away with this. Scree!
The gremlin is defeated. I thought I was going to speak with the again. That's him dealt with, but why did we change back to humans all of a sudden? Look up there on the wall, that's Ra's mirror. This legendary looking glass is said to reveal the true form of all it reflects. I thought it would last forever. Never imagined the monster's had it all along. Huh, so that's what made us drop our disguises. We cannot leave so powerful a relic in the monster's hands. Let's take it with us, along with the flurry feathers. Just as obtains Ra's mirror. And that's to make sure you get it.
Bow, bow, bish, bosh. Bang.
What's that? You've been sent to collect all of our flurry feathers? Well, you say that, but can you really be trusted? I know, I'll ask you some questions that only a loyal member of the squadron could answer. Question the first. What's the name of our squadron? Is it the Care Force? No. You think so, do you? Alright, my second question is about the army that was defeated by the horrid humans of Moonbrook, the Hair Force. What's the commander of Power Yowie? No. An interesting response. Final question then, including myself. Are there three pretty purple gremlins in this camp, no more, no less? Well, technically no, because I killed one. But, let's say yes. Well, if you say so, now let's see how you did. A perfect score! Well, that proves it. You're a member of our Lucius Order, alright. Here you go, the float feathers are quickly all yours. By a crate floating in some water. I assumed it would be near the guy who wanted me to get them. But once I do that, I can't get normal water again. I mean, it's only hurting me one. I might just be able to get it. Although I am very slow. Falling in was a mistake. There we go. Get out. You can't jump one tile as a... Oh, you can. There we go. I'm free! Don't see this floating crate I'm supposed to be seeing. But either way. Close the bomb was popped with poison. That's not the right source block. That's all clear now. Don't know how far I can really go without being seen, but... I'm making an attempt. Let's get rid of all that poison real quick. I don't think it was this pool. Although poison could be a good natural defense. Actually. I think this is the source block. If I get rid of that, oh, yeah, it'll be gone. Friendly guy. Oh, there's the crate. I see it now. Do the ghosts get fooled by the mod rod too? Huge if true. Air Force, you must have a death wish, and that one we'd be happy to grant. Everyone attack! Plus, they've seen us fall back. I thought maybe we were like succubi. If we were to find out the secret to defeating the monsters, we must take care not to be spotted. Use the mod rod to transform us to monsters. The fiends will know the difference. We'll have them in the place. Yep. Hello. You've scattered all the flummy feathers. Excellent work. And just in time, too, I feel a storm coming with those feathers who can safely... Suffering succotash, it's a tornado! Everyone back inside the base, quickly! Oh no, we're too late, it's coming this way, squee!
Now that whirlwind really was something, we're lucky we didn't get blown away ourselves. I see, since the troops in the Air Force are constantly in flight, they're susceptible to strong winds. What say you, Giuseppe, so this knowledge and the flurry feathers we collected, do you think you could invent a weapon to work against them? At any rate, our work here is done. Come, let us return to the castle. Yurika, just learns a new recipe, a whoosh widget, a weapon of war that blows encroaching your enemies away with gusting gales, which knocks airborne enemies to the ground, too. Can I warp as a monster? Yeah. So I can also mod into a showgirl for some reason. It's fine, it's just... Wait, something doesn't feel right here. Oh, just ever thank the goddess you hear, something terrible has happened. What's going on here? Are they dead? Slain in the night and buried, they bear wounds from a sword and not one of the monsters, one of our own. Then it is true. A monster hides among us, a fiend disguised in human form.
But if so, how in creation can we hope to find the perpetrator if only had Razmir would be able to dispel the illusion? Egad, Giuseppe, is that Razmir? Quickly, let's use it to expose the traitor in our midst. This is of our business, Your Majesty, but I fear we have no alternative. We cannot be sure of our safety until we check every last citizen of Moonbrook. You're seriously going to go through with this? What's wrong with you people? Don't any of you trust each other? You seem strangely opposed to finding the spy mouth, almost suspiciously so. Enough, you two. This is exactly what the enemy wants, to sow the seeds of doubt and distrust among us. All must gaze into the mirror, including you, Maroth. Come to service, use the Razmir and let our truth forms be revealed. You may begin with us, your closest allies, if that's alright with you, Inessa. Yes, fine. Let's get this over with. Service peers into Razmir. For some reason, Maroth doesn't have a reflection. Huh? Isn't this thing supposed to show your true form? It's not showing anything at all. But more to the point, why did you do that? I guess you just don't trust me, and I thought we were friends. Yep. I did it because the game told me to. It shows nothing but a reflection of myself. I think it should be enough to clear me of any suspicion. I see my own face. I suppose that means I'm not a monster. What a relief! Razmir has showed us the truth. These three who are who they claim, though quite what Maroth's lack of affection heralds, I know not. Now, just of us, pray hold Razmir to the other citizens of the Moonbrook. The traitor must be found and dealt with. Yep. Oh, nothing in this mirror but the dashingly handsome King of Moonbrook looking back at me. But to doubt even me, what dark thoughts lie behind that innocent smile of yours? I had to do it. Always check the priest. Oh, what a relief, there's nobody in my reflection but me. You know, I think Maroth's right. Doubting each other like this is a ghastly thing to do. Maybe we really haven't any other option. Yep. What a relief, all I see in the mirror is my own reflection. I saw something in the mirror look like... Look, a horrible scary monster! Razmir reveals that three of the townspeople are skeletons in disguise. It cannot be, my faithful citizens were monsters all along.
Took you long enough to find us. Come on, boys, let's show these boneheads what we're really made of.
The monsters are defeated. You shouldn't have came into a base full of people with swords. And that's that.
Thank you, Giuseppe. No longer shall we be forced to suffer from the monsters' malicious machinations. And yet it is chilling to think that the fiends have been living among us for so long unnoticed.
I trained with them, worked with them, ate with them, and they were plotting against us all the while.
Whatever their wicked schemes, the saboteurs have been dealt with. Now we can rest easy for a time.
Your Majesty would urge us to remain vigilant. It is not only the shadows of monsters that are glimpsed in the dead of night, but the of men meeting with them. Boric is right. I think it would be wise to conduct periodic checks on the citizens we. To that end, Josephus, would we trust Rosmir to my care.
Yeah.
Thank you, I'll make good use of it. I'll do everything in my power to ensure the monsters do not infiltrate our ranks again. Josephus, if you'd be so kind, would you see to the burial of our fallen comrades, or companions? They died as heroes, so it's only right they may be properly remembered.
Yeah, but where are they, though? Ah, over here. Southgate.
Yep.
I know this is needlessly long. But I've got to do it because I already set up the gravesite over here, so I've got to do it this way. I know jumping with a corpse is also, you know, poor form. Poor form. I'll be back. Going. Okay. Yes. Body 2. I'm sorry we didn't save you in time. We couldn't find the monsters in our midst, and you suffered the ultimate price. But your deaths will not be in vain, for we now know how to sniff out these fools. Bosh. Nice. Now we can snow all this in and we can... What a sentence I never thought I'd hear. I need some whoosh widgets. Give me a fucking whoosh widget, mate. Rest easy, friends. Make exactly 2. So there really were monsters hiding when we saw that time. How awful. I don't know whether to be relieved that we finally found them or appalled that they were among us in the first place. I simply don't know who to trust anymore. Oh, in all the excitement I almost forgot. Did you learn anything of note of the air force base? Some weakness we can exploit? Some weapon by which we might defeat them? You've had an idea for a whoosh widget that harnesses the power of wind, while those should certainly be put those flying rotters into a flap. So, Joseph, I was speaking to Sister Esther about the soldiers who were killed. She told me that they were all stabbed in the back with a sword from our very own armory. Certainly they could have been slain by a monster disguised as a man, but it could not also be that they were slain by a man who had been turned by the monsters. There may yet be traitors among us. You have all the knowledge you need to complete the blueprint now, but watch your back out there, Josephus, lest you be stabbed in it. For good buddy. These widgets must be quite big. Oh, they're 2x2. I mean, I know I could do it myself as well, but... Eh, fuck it. Come on. Any more blocks. Interesting. I think I might have just never put them in the chest. forgot. It's alright, doesn't matter. All the main bits done, just haven't got the last little bit. And these two spikes. If that is indeed where spikes live. No. Did I ever put the barricades in there either? No. There we go. They're in there now. Well, up, 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 up. Beep, 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 pop. Lovely. Oh, you guys are beautiful. Look at all this shit. What else is there? Ah, it's just the buttress and the battlements, which I didn't do, but they can do now. Yeah, the frame rate is just what's happening in the game. It's not the picture. Please do not adjust your sets. Sorted my inventory. We should be pretty close to completion now. Just gonna be it's just gonna be these. If I find out where they need to go, I could probably do it myself. It's mostly just the accenting now. This place looks very, very dangerous. I love it. You'd die instantaneously if you ever actually got stuck in here. You'd never make it through. You know, people peppering you with arrows as you're trying to break the siege, but you can't because you have to be careful and be slow to avoid this shit. And then time it between the zappy wall. And then go around the outside edge of this. All while not being killed. Just not likely to happen, is it? Service completes the anti-air force fortifications blueprint. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Great. Maybe don't thank me in the flames. It's a bit dangerous. Hello. Spiffing work in this blueprint just surface where those whoosh bridges in place, the defenses are complete. The whirlwinds those devices send forth will pluck the air force from the skies and throw them at our feet, ready for our soldiers to cut them down. That's if our soldiers are still in a position to fight. I fear there may be still traitors in our midst. That is a concern, but so is Maroth. Why did Vazmir reveal no reflection of him whatsoever? I know he's your friend, Josephus, but there's something inhuman about that man. I cannot help but feel unsettled in his presence. I know what unsettles me, the thought of the people of Moonbrook doubting and distrusting one another. Questioning the townsfolk's loyalties will do exactly that. If there's a spy among us, we must have no choice but to wait for them to slip up. But what's going on? Are we under attack? Looks like we've got the Air Force's attention. They're back again in numbers this time. Josephus, my lad, did you build plenty of boom balls like suggested? This ought to serve you well. What do you say, Josephus? Are you ready to fight? Yeah, I am. I don't need no boom balls. I just wanted to know, when you used that mirror on me, it really hurt. Mm-hmm. But now's not the time to be talking about feelings and stuff. We need to get out there and clobber those monsters. Just remember, Joseph, an Esser and Warwick might be pretty tough, but if you want some sucker smashed to smithereens, I'm your man. Don't forget who your friends are, eh? Again, I literally did it because the game told me to. I wonder if you can do it without searching him. I'm just like, nah, I don't want to search him. I know my friend Mawoth's good. He's a good friend. I need to use the other one of these to start getting them to stick. Stay until they turn off, then kill them. Because we want to fight them in this fuck zone. Here we go. Look at all this destruction, I love it. You girls just don't get it. We're all sat here waiting. And now we go and attack. It's literally the only job you have to do. Is not go forward all the time. I like the idea of building my own fuck dungeons though in the Isle of Awakening. Gotta fight him myself. Because he broke through. I don't think any enemies are supposed to break through. Fucking come here. Dickhead. You sad fool. Bye bye. See how much trouble you caused me? Now I'm gonna come back and help you out because you wouldn't go back to where you're supposed to go.
Impudent humans, I'll slay all myself and then peck the meat from your bones.
Cosmic Chimera. The Air Force is awful, Admiral. Come then. Kill him. You stand no chance. Give up now. You cannot hope to defeat us. How dare you? Bye. Just have some arts level increases. Yes. Mouth gets stronger and just ever reaches level 28. His maximum HP increase. Yuriko just ever learns a new recipe. Yay! Magic armor. Gaudy green armor made from magical metal. Defense plus 48. Reduces fire and ice damage. Victory!
Squawk! Featherbrained humans, why do you fight your fate? You may have defeated me, but the Scare Force are still waiting in the wings. Squawk! Squawk! Squawk!
Yes. We did it, just as the Air Force is defeated. Jolly good show, just as we couldn't have done it without your whoosh widgets and really saved the day. But the war's not won yet. We must take care not to underestimate the Scare Force. Let us gird up our loins and bring all our strength to bear in the final battle. Speaking of which, we'd better repair the cats before these scary so-and-sos come wandering our way, hmm? Fear not, Josephus, we're building builders of the whole place to look back like it was in a jiffy. Base restored to its former glory. Defeat the Air Force. Complete. How about that then, Josephus? Good as new, I'd say. Hello, hello, what the devil's going on up there? So now I need to find out why we're still screwed. Ah. We're still screwed because they're armored and they don't give a shit about the wind or the fire. And they hit like a goddamn freight train. Sorry, I can't help, very hungry. Hit him.
Phew, it was a hard battle, but we finally managed to lay them low. There must have been a Scare Force scouting expedition. The beasts barely flinched when they hit our zap traps. If they were to attack en masse, we'd have no hope of stopping them.
Ho-ho! Do not fret, Sir Onessa, my dear. Fear not, for I have the answer to your woes. In times of great vexation, you must go straight to sleep. You will awaken refreshed and invigorated, and the path you must take will be clear to you.
Thank you, Your Majesty. Truly, your wisdom knows no bounds.
The same goes for you too, just as you have earned your rest, we shall begin our preparations anew on the Mauer.
You have a gift for me, I see. Once again, you prove your usefulness. Thank you, Father.
But two of Hargon's heroes lie slain, their forces scattered to the winds. Verily, the two you spoke of are irritations indeed, the accursed Builder and Mawoth. Still, it is as you say, no matter how hard they fight it, the humans cannot escape their fate. When doomsday comes, death awaits them all.
Please, Father, spare me from this fate. Let me live.
Lord Atlas makes his way here as we speak. Should your efforts continue to yield results, he shall surely grant your wish.
Lovely. Josephus, I've been thinking, from whence do your beliefs, or do our beliefs, arise? They say the teachings of the children of Hargon are absolute, but no knowledge one discovers is ever absolute. Were they then not revealed to us, but imposed? For so long, we of Moonbrook believed it to be our sacred duty to fight forevermore, but if this is truly not the will of the heavens, and merely a rule set by another, then I...
Hey. What are you two lovebirds nattering about? Forget it. Josephus, Rogue wants to see you.
That's the Air Force dealt with, then we just have to give the Scare Force the same treatment.
I thought we were going to talk about how annoyed you were with me.
Josephus, we must begin work on a new magical weapon if we hope to mount an effective defense against the Scare Force. But before that, I think it's high time you gave the Builder's Bell another good ring, don't you? Every time you do, we gain new allies and grow as both soldiers and builders, improving our chances of facing down our foes. So go on, Josephus, amass all the adultery...
Amass all the adulatory energies you require by seeing to the townsfolk's needs, and pour all that vim and vigor into ringing the bell.
Gadsooks, Josephus, we've given Harkon's armies a jolly good hiding, all that remains the Scare Force, and with you on our side, I bet we'll have that lot trounced in a jiffy. Soon enough, peace shall reign in Moonbrook, and long may it last, under the enlightened rule of our wise and gracious king. He's a good, kind man, the man of the people, but more than that, he's a symbol of Moonbrook. He deserves a throne room befitting his status. We must do away with that awful, disfigured throne, replaced with something more magnificent. The room itself could do with being a good piece larger, too. Which brings me to my request. I'd have you repair the throne and build an enormous repair throne room within which to place it, the largest royal hall ever seen. And simply add four bold banners and a brace of braziers in the same chamber, and voila, His Majesty's new throne room is complete.
I've got a disfigured throne, need to build a new one. Good thing I haven't taken all of my food. I'd be most displeased. There, okay. Need braziers. Forget how many, but we'll find out. A throne. A nice throne. Bold banners. And then braziers too. It needs to be enormous as well, he said. I guess I can put it anywhere, right? This still counts as the base. This doesn't count as the base. So the throne room can go, like, here. And this will count as enormous. I'll change this into something else, but... Let's just hope the game doesn't want me to put anything else anywhere else. Because that's not going to happen. Okay, here we go. Are there actual graves under here? No, this is where they wanted me to put the graves, and I was like, nah. Alright, so, need to make sure it's all nice wall. Like that. Like so. Don't worry, I'm gonna use the old tool. floor as well, because why not? It's gotta look proper. It's gotta be fit for a king, literally. So for some reason, this isn't counting as a proper room. I guess it's because some of the blocks don't count as blocks. Again, I'm guessing. That would be my guess. My next guess is to make this, like, down here. So it's counting. Right, let's do this. Start from here. So this should start counting from here. It might be too large as well. That's a possibility. Well, let's cut a bit off of it and see if that helps. Like, let's say this bit. It won't take a lot. For it to go. Oh, okay, no, this is fine now. All I need to do is make some more castle walls and just start experimenting until it goes. Yeah, this is fine. I think it's too big. But we'll see. Everything else you can do other things with. This should be big enough now, it should be fine. There we go. It's basically on the limit of what is acceptable. Wait, what? Oh. I was like, how can that be? So now these other bits get turned into other rooms at some point. If I need them. Which means I can almost certainly do that as well. There we go. We're quite close to the next level. Speak to my boy.
You gorgeous house is maybe the finest throne we've ever seen, and finally our king has a chamber befitting his might and majesty.
Ho 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 ho, what have we here? marvelous creation indeed, young Josephus. Verily, our mission is not merely a matter of winning a war, but of building a nation. This noble chamber will inspire me to similar nobility in my dealings with the common folk, and lend my words the royal authority they deserve.
It seems your work pleases his majesty, Josephus. Now, I wonder if I could speak to you about Maroth. Your friend fights like a wild beast on the battlefield. His might is unquestionable, but it is terrifying to behold. I'm not the only one who feels this way. Many of my fellow soldiers feel the same fear when they fight alongside him. His ferocity may win battles, but is losing hearts and minds. I know he is your friend, and it may hurt to hear this, but there is something amiss about that man, something different. It's a shame I don't care. Josephus, my lamb, we have won a great many battles of late, but at what price? The brave soldiers who lost their lives in the defense of our home were fully aware of the risks, but now perhaps they may find the peace that they were denied in life. To this end, Josephus, I humbly beg that you build me a chapel, a holy place wherein we might pray for the repose of the souls who will perish in this accursed war. Yes, I've got just the place. Josephus draws out a Moonbrook Chapel blueprint. There's a little spot in the corner that would be just perfect for it. The design you've drawn for the chapel looks just how I imagined it, my lamb. If you were to place a chest nearby and fill it with materials, I'm sure the people of Moonbrook would be eager to aid in its construction. Yeah, but I need to get the actual space for the blueprint first. I've got to clear all of this out, and then I know exactly what I'm dealing with. Alright. It's a lot wider than I thought. I mean, this is okay. This should go here. Chest. With all the bits in that I need. Oh, they can do it from over here. It doesn't need to be... Huh. That's interesting. Right, let me check how much I actually need of everything. It should tell me because I've got a blueprint down. Yeah. Thirty of these. Yes. Good. I hate only being able to make in sets of 10. 10 stained glass windows. Beautiful. One door. 2 candles. 1 altar. 1 goddess statue. I know what I'm gonna do. Even if it's just for the looks of it. Back off. Don't think there's anything else. Okay. What the? What the fuck happened here? They destroyed it.
And I guess that's why you put all the materials in the chest, and then when you get the next thing, they make sure the old thing is also done. That makes more sense now. Don't you do that. You... Assholes. Absolute assholes. I think we've got all the materials they need now. Go on, get to building. It's coming along a tree. You keep building, I'll go get this material. And then make a shit ton more of everything so that they can rebuild the castle when the time's right. Because I ain't doing it. Hell no. I think I might need more than that. Let's go for 900. And then some portcullises, some extra ones just in case. I was supposed to use the throne room door, but nah. There. Now they can rebuild this when it matters. Yeah, I want to have, like, a secret door leading out of the chapel into the throne room so that the king has, like, his own personal access. But since the chapel's position isn't perfect, I'm just going to leave it. Go on, you lads. Come on. Jacket Tater. Lovely. Get some jacket tater out and then eat that. And then eat the stir fry. Jefferson completes the Moonbrook Chapel blueprint. Bup, bup. It's not like it's my actual name or anything. Okay, pop. Hiya. Goddess be praised, the chapel is complete. Thank you so much, Josephus. I shall pray for our fallen friends each and every day so that their souls may find the peace they were denied in life. Having a place to pray will also make our fellow townsfolk feel a little less anxious about the afterlife, and I'm sure they will show you their eternal appreciation for that. My grandfather and I were never taken in by the Children of Hargon's teachings. We had to act like faithful followers for fear of what the monsters might do to us if we didn't. But now I'm free to say that creation trumps destruction every time. I believe in you, Josephus. As for your friend Mawarth, he has been in a terribly foul mood of late. Has something happened? A lot of the soldiers are wary of him, but I know that beneath his fearsome exterior he has a kind heart. Please forgive the townspeople their misgivings. You two are such good friends, it breaks my heart to think the base rumor might tear you apart. Never. Okay. I'll see you guys next time when we speak to Old Man Jeremiah and see what he's got to say. See ya.